Yo, yo, yo. Welcome back to the Long and Hard podcast. This week we have a very, very special guest.
Our mysterious third partner, aka Dylan, who was part of some of our earliest ventures. And we did some weird gimmicky learn how to make money sort of things. And we recanted that a little bit. Dylan's kind of the first friend of the show we're having on, just to give a little refreshment to you guys who are sick of hearing me and Josh all the time.
So if you want to come on the show on evenings, we do have beers available.
No. for select friends. Other friends, BYOB.
Oh, you don't want to be footing the bill for everybody? Mm-hmm. That's funny. Yeah, in this episode, we talk a little bit about our first couple ventures, about Dylan's accounting career. We get to watch Thomas cough while he opens a beer.
Yeah, that was really funny. Hopefully there's an Instagram clip, and apparently that's one of the highlights of the episode, so it's a good thing you can skip all the rest of it. So
you're underselling it. Yeah, it's a pretty good episode.
No, that was it was a fun episode.
Lots of laughs.
Oh, quite a bit of just horsing around as per usual. Nothing too serious, no real specific agenda here or anything on this one. So we also did give out Josh's phone number, so if we don't edit that out, ladies, listen out for that.
Gentlemen, whichever, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean,
or
if you wanna
potential business associates.
I mean, if you want to have a nice conversation with me, I'm a pretty nice guy, so. Mm-hmm.
Actually, sorry, so if you want to be a guest on the show, you have to listen to this episode, find Josh's phone number, and then call Josh. And then book your time.
Yeah, leave me a message. I'm not going to answer any strange phone numbers now. Yeah. Fuck you guys.
All right, well, without further ado, we're going to get into it. This is, I don't even know what to call it. Episode 17.
Dylan Ferentz.
Yeah, all right, well, we'll take it away here. Yeah. Kicks.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. Man, I don't know if I should drink this because I've been fasting all fucking day.
Like all day?
I'm like 22 hours into a fast right now.
What?
You know what, dude? I had coffee this morning.
Why are you doing such a long one?
I don't know. I had coffee this morning and it felt like I could fucking hear in colors. Like it was actually it's pretty fucked, man. So so thanks for giving me this.
Yeah, it'll
be deeply inebriated for this podcast.
Yeah, Josh is going to have one light beer.
It would be over for me, Jesus Christ.
Over tea kettle. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's funny. So, like why? Like, are you on, like, a cleanse or something?
No, dude, I want to get cut.
Were you going to starve yourself?
Yeah, dude, I'm going to get cut.
Model diet or,
Don't fucking say that. God damn it.
Is he coming with
So welcome to the fucking podcast, by the way.
Yeah, thanks for joining us.
No problem.
A little refreshing, guys. Have a third voice, not just me and Josh rambling to each other about how smart we are, right?
So
yeah.
Fucking friends of the podcast.
Friends of the show.
Yeah.
First guest?
First guest.
Well, technically, I was the first guest.
Yeah, I read that. Sorry. I don't know how that works.
Second guest. But by the time people hear this, you will be effectively the third guest because we'll do it next week. So
Yeah, we're backlogging you.
Shit.
Yeah, sorry, man. You're getting put in the library, so.
God, okay. How's shit going, man? I haven't seen you in, like, fucking 3 weeks.
Pretty good.
I saw you that one time I got back from Montreal, and then I haven't seen you since.
Moved out.
Yeah, you moved out.
Back at home.
Went to fucking...
chilling.
Yeah, go fucking guys back at home. Racking up dough so you can buy investment properties and stuff.
Yeah, that's smart. Like, Dylan, if you're looking for a good investment opportunity, right around the Coliseum.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the football field.
Yeah, I've seen a couple of those.
Oh, yeah. There's some nice ROI on some of those.
We've looked at a few of those ourselves. What, 5 years ago?
It took you a minute to figure out that one.
Holy fuck, yeah.
Yeah.
In Chinatown, too.
What's our friend's name?
Don't say it. We're gonna not throw specific people under the bus on this show, okay? We can tell stories, like, anonymously.
Yeah, but... anonymous stories.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, God. That was a little sketchy.
Yeah, going to it for investment properties. And Chinatown, that's where you gotta go for investment properties, I think.
I actually drove past that place the other day.
It's still alive?
Oh, yeah, it's still there.
Really?
It's still between the two commercial buildings or whatever. But,
Jesus.
Same staircase on the back, or is it falling off yet?
I drove... the fire escape, yeah. I drove past the front of it, and I was like... Well, I'm driving down 97th Street or for whatever fucking reason, and I'm like... Slowing down, I'm like, I swear this was around here somewhere. And then I like... Like, oh my god, there it is. But it's way smaller than I remember.
Oh, dude, it was
it's tiny. Yeah, fuck. It's a tiny little house, and it's two, like, large commercial buildings on either side of it.
Right? Yeah.
And so, did you realize how many fucking families were living in that thing?
I think it was it eight rooms?
I think nine. Like
that? Eight rooms?
There was
house?
Nine
yeah.
of them.
Yeah, for you, those yeah, of you out there, is. Rooming yeah. houses.
I'm trying to remember, though, there was something different about it. Like, the sides were, like, because remember how he put cages on the sides? The dude who owned it?
I'm just staring at you blankly because I don't
know. Oh, okay. Yeah, well, anyways, I don't know. It was like boarded up. Something was different. Anyways.
Oh, something was different this time.
Yeah. Something looked different. It looked in worse shape.
They probably only had four families in there now.
Yeah, so. Oh, one more space. All right, Josh, recant that story from the start so people know what the fuck we're talking about.
Did we find it on Kijiji?
Yes.
It must have been.
Yeah, it was Kijiji.
Yeah.
It was an MLS.
Yeah, and we contacted the guy and we wanted to do like seller financing for it.
Vendor take back.
Yeah, so he would like front the bill on the mortgage. And
also, funny story. So I went through my stuff one day to like, I was like determined to figure out the address of that home.
Mm.
And like going through our old emails and stuff or old.
Did you find the contract?
I did. But then the address of the home was completely wrong.
Okay,
like nice. It wasn't even remotely right. Like it was like. Three blocks over, we had some random fucking address on it.
No, so. Do you remember a Kijiji ad we had for people that were looking to sell a home, and we would basically sell it for them through a rent-to-own agreement?
Yes.
Oh, God.
I don't remember actually the ad, but...
I might have a copy here, actually.
Do you?
Yeah, I was going through my Google Drive, and...
Holy shit, you're probably going to read it on air here.
Yeah,
oh, God. See if I can find it.
I mean, if the real estate council is watching, we didn't officially do this or anything, so...
You were not agents at the time.
Yeah.
No one was
Dylan listening. Did all of this. We had nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
So...
But it was our first foray into real estate.
Yeah, it was. So, just to, like, really reel it back to the start, so people... Because not everyone knows what the fuck we're talking about
yeah,
right
now. Yeah, in 1993, but, I was born. Yeah,
so... Yeah, kindergarten started, I want to say about 1998, 1999, but...
you got held back?
Yeah. No, you would... Yeah, it was 98, because you're five and turned six in.
Sure,
anyways.
Sure.
Okay, so, number one, we watched all these YouTube real estate investing videos that taught you all these ridiculous things, like how to make money, like no money down, like just stupid stuff for how to supposedly make money.
Yeah.
Like
you should probably tell everyone we were poor university students at the time.
That's also an important pre-qualifier for it. So,
yeah.
But anyways, we got this wise idea. We were going to somehow pool our resources, us three, and purchase like a rental property, right?
Mm-hmm.
But then we got the bright idea to purchase like what's called a rooming house. And it's essentially like a two and a half story home, but they've...
There's like 10 families living in it.
They make it into like 7, 8, or 9 like individual suites kind of where you'll have like it's basically a bunch of master bedrooms.
I think it's purpose built though because there's hallways through the middle of the home, and on each side of the it almost looks like a hotel.
See, I think
a really like a 1-star hotel,
like a 0.5 star hotel.
See that's a good point. And then the interesting thing is a lot of those buildings are super old, like those are in like 1920s.
Yeah.
So it was either purpose built or someone like. Redid them at some point, right?
Yeah.
But anyways, so they had so it would have like 8 suites in it, give or take, right? So you could get a couple $100 per. So in theory, on paper, you make all this money for them.
It's $500 a suite.
Yeah.
This is just so I can fall asleep while he's telling the story.
Yeah, exactly. We'll wake you up at the next next pause here. But now, also, further to that, rooming suites are typically, or rooming houses are only in, statistically speaking, lower income areas, right?
You're saying it very nicely.
Yeah.
sketchy parts of town. I know my demographics of Edmonton fairly well, right? Mm. So, but then, yeah, so we got the spread idea and we went and looked at it, and we, like, Josh and I weren't agents at the time, so we hired an agent, you know, bless her heart. and so we go to these places, and she's like, okay. Right? And we're talking, like, yeah, right around the football stadium and then kind of just in sort of Chinatown.
What's that high school? There's one across from the one where we first met her, the first time we met her. She was actually representing
that's condo. That's St. Joe's or
St. Joe's.
Yeah, just down the street.
That area, okay.
Yeah, that one. These one, like, that was a step up, frankly.
That was a step up, yeah. But that was like a just sub 100K condo.
Yeah.
I think it was 90.
Yeah.
Was it?
Yeah, you can get 60K condos now.
I was about to say, those walk-ups are like 60 grand or something. Yeah,
so. Oof.
Yeah, those are rough. Oof. Man, there's a lot of people who paid like 200 some odd for some of those in like 07. Like that was the craziest market for sure.
That's how you buy the building.
Yeah.
For 200 something.
Yeah. So, long and the short of it, we went, so...
Long and the hard of it.
I was just thinking. So, bright idea to try and buy a rental. Looked at rentals in super sketchy areas. Thank God we didn't buy any, but we also found one. It was in Chinatown, in like, not in the neighborhood, like residential. It was like between two buildings, this random little house.
Yeah.
Right?
Two Chinese food restaurants.
Yeah. Then we decided we were going to, the whole time our plan was to supposedly seller finance it, because that's what our YouTube investing videos told us to do.
The guy essentially told us to fuck off.
Yeah.
That was fun.
We actually wrote an offer or whatever on it. And, like...
That contract was hilarious.
Who? Did you guys write that?
Like, yeah.
From scratch.
Yeah. No, from you know scratch. He's got a template off the fucking internet.
No, there was zero template. That was...
Are you sure?
That was written by hand.
Oh, my God. I would love to see that fucking...
It was bad.
I'm curious.
Holes in it.
I bet it's got to be somewhere on someone's computer. I would love to see that. So
I still use my U of A email, and I think it's on there somewhere.
Yeah.
Nice. You need to find that for us.
Yeah, we'll find that.
That would be like one of our thumbnails for this fucking for this episode.
Yeah. Well, but there's even like a community of that. Like, people do that, right? Like, I knew a guy who actually did the supposed intermediary, like assignments and all that nonsense sort of stuff.
Yeah.
And I was talking to him about it, and he's like, honestly, it's so much work for like a little bit of money. Like,
guy at our old company?
No. Friend of a friend. I'll tell you. But, you know, he tried to do that and like it worked, but like the amount of like extra work it was to like save the money of getting your real estate license, he's like, fuck, I might as well just be a real estate agent.
Right.
So,
yeah.
And all the people you deal with are like super cheap, and everyone wants to use their own Microsoft Word contracts, and
yeah.
They're not exactly airtight.
No luck, eh?
No luck.
That's too bad.
We'll try and find that later.
Yeah.
We'll put a Dropbox link in the show notes so people can go look at it. So
yeah, how not to write a real estate contract.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, so, yeah. Not all of our fucking ventures were failures, though.
No. But that was that was also when we got interested in real estate, because, I mean, it's sort of a two-way street of, like, there's a lot of crappy agents out there, but when you're looking at like 100 grand properties or less, like, a lot of realtors like won't get out of bed for that.
No, they're gonna get $3,500 bucks from it.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe.
Best case scenario.
Yeah, right? So. Unless the seller negotiated lower. So.
Yeah.
So there's that.
Yeah, this is true. So. Yeah, fucking irrigation boys.
Yeah, irrigation boys here. I actually saw Dane's truck outside of my old office one time. Like, he was just parked there.
Oh, yeah.
He must have been doing a job
or lunch
or something. And I'm like, I like ran in. I'm like, guys, look, Dane. It brings a tear to my eye, because he has like an enclosed trailer as well.
Yeah, from Flamin or Flamin, whatever it's called. Yeah.
And I'm like, so beautiful. Good thing we sold that $0.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, you're welcome.
He's got a big blown up poster inside. It's a donkey with a safety vest on looking at some blueprints.
Does he actually? No. Oh, that would have been so good.
Fuck, man, that's so
funny. Maybe that should be the cover logo for for this.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
What did it say? I have not.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
That was the company motto. You just go in and do it.
This is true.
Just go on YouTube or the internet. You can figure it out.
Yeah. Are you trying to pull this fucker? Yeah, he found it.
It's literally first try.
That's 100% what it was.
well, for
the
sure.
The donkey's got a hard hat on, too.
Yeah.
And a safety vest.
Yeah, and a safety vest. He's wearing pants, too, actually, for whatever reason.
Unreal.
Definitely. Oh, man. So, in our first company, we... first one that actually sort of made money.
I'm going to... You explain it first, and I got something to add, but...
Okay. So, there's this meme, and it's a donkey wearing a vest and hard hat, looking at blueprints, and in, like, the classic meme writing, it's, I have no idea what I'm doing. So, that was, like, literally our mantra for months. Or, like, it would be, like, anytime we would text our group chat or anything, be like, hey, did you find that part? Just reply with the donkey meme. Or I'd be like, hey, someone screwed up this section of the system at so-and-so's house. Donkey.
Drilling a hole in somebody's wall.
Donkey. Yeah. Where's the client? I don't want to see them. Want them to see me looking stuff up on YouTube.
You know what's hilarious? Though, the first job that we did actually was pretty good because they were gone when we were doing the whole job.
Remember? It didn't work, though.
It wasn't our fault.
It wasn't our fault. Yeah, wasn't our fault, that was though. Them, and they were a plumbing company, and they should have known better. But to put it into perspective, you can start any company you want. If you look at me, most people don't think I've ever lifted a hammer in my life.
Yeah, can I see your fucking hands?
Yeah, this guy. I came upstairs with jeans on and like a black T-shirt, and my mom's like, "What the fuck?" I think it was a Sunday morning at like 8:30. She's like, "What are you doing?"
Yeah,
I'm like. I started an irrigation company last week, going to a client. She's like, how do you know? You don't know how to do that. I'm like, I looked on the internet.
And watched a couple hours of YouTube.
YouTube, we're good.
That's honestly, like, that's always my argument about, like, I'll just say, like, ridiculous shit, like, Earth is flat, global warming's a myth, blah, blah, blah. And then I'll just be like, I have watched several hours of YouTube videos on this. I think I know what I'm talking about.
Absolutely, dude.
Goddamn YouTube experts.
We looked legit though. Rolling up, we had a Bobcat,
yeah,
a big Escalade.
Well, that wasn't the first job we did. The first job we did, we probably pulled up in your mom's like Subaru. I want to say, and we had all the pipe in the back.
No, I think it was something like that. Yeah.
Well, I remember. You know what I remember? So, the Sequoia model that we had, there was actually a design flaw where the handle like hitch to. Open the back door open the trunk would break, so you couldn't open it, like you would click the thing and nothing would happen because it would become detached, right? And it's just like a design flaw with that body model of Sequoias, right?
Yeah,
so that happened that year. So to put stuff in the back of my truck, it was a big SUV, we had to roll down the back window.
Dude, we had a fucking trencher in the back of Jake's Suburban. Do you remember that?
I think I remember that. Yeah, I do remember
so that. That yellow thing from Snowbird. Yeah.
From Snowbird.
Yeah, but the one you had to like it.
Like the shitty one.
It was shit. Yeah, it didn't have like treads or wasn't automated at all. Shit. So.
You know what, dude? When I brought it back to the guy, because I went back by myself because we were like, didn't want to pay more for it because we had rented it for like 3 fucking hours or something.
Yeah.
And I took it back to the guy. He's like, okay, get it out of there. I'm like, bro, this thing weighs like 300 pounds. Yeah. It's awkward as fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck those people.
Your
fuck,
lower body strength was still recovering.
Fuck Snowbird, dude.
They're out of business.
Yeah, they got bought.
Yeah.
They got bought by a. And now it looks way nicer. Yeah. Like, they put better money into it.
Do you remember when we rented that really small U-Haul trailer and tried to put that big trencher in it? And it wasn't working.
Yeah, it was a motorcycle
this guy
trailer.
Got so fucking mad. He's like, we can't put it in here. We're not doing this today. I'm like, Thomas, it's okay. We're going to put it in. It might fall out. That's why I bought the insurance.
Yeah, and then we put it on the back of my dad's, like, 30-foot trailer. Is the little fucking... Like, the,
yeah.
I know which
one. Yeah, exactly. Your dad had...
Yeah.
You're like, don't worry. Because, yeah, we used a motorcycle trailer to try and move this trencher.
Yeah.
It was and cheap.
Then, yeah, but, like, those motorcycle trailers are really hard
I
to navigate.
I wasn't there that day,
right?
Thank
yeah, you
no.
were there.
Nice.
And then... But then you're like, don't worry, boys. My dad has a trailer. I actually... Fuck, I hope... God...
I'll find a picture of it.
Yeah.
You know what, dude? I have a picture of the Escalade with the trailer with the fucking Bobcat on the back.
Thank God.
I have a picture
honestly,
of that.
Honestly, though, like, those days, like, people took pictures less of things, or at least we did, right? So unfortunately, we don't have as good of artsy Instagram photos.
I do have that photo, though. Don't you worry.
Josh has, like, this full 30-foot, like, flatbed trailer.
You could fit two Bobcats on it if you wanted to.
With, comfortably, right? Yeah, and easily. Then we had this one little trencher with, like, the tie-downs barely reached the other side. Oh, man. So anyways, I guess the point of it all is, I don't know, make it up as you go along and you eventually figure it out.
Yeah, if you're moderately intelligent, you can figure most things out yourself. Business,
right? So,
that's true, yeah. Like, I've never put a pipe in the ground until we started doing that shit. And all of a sudden, I'm an irrigation technical specialist, you know?
No, I told my mom I'm probably going to be building a house come this fall. And she's like, oh, who are you going to get to build? I'm like, who? Well, no, me. Can't be that hard. Like, I'm not going to build. Sorry, let me rephrase that. I'm not going to actually lift a hammer.
Yeah.
But I don't need a general contractor to go. And why would I pay someone 20 to 30% extra?
Yeah, that's fair.
Maybe. Yeah, if you're willing to. Yeah, if you want to GC it. Yeah. But yeah, I've seen a lot of. Like, yeah, you can learn anything from YouTube, but I've seen a lot of YouTube renos in my line of work. They almost never look good. So, yeah.
Just flip a fucking house.
To be That's enough. Worse when I, yeah.
Just do the special, the IKEA special. And
yeah, honestly. Well.
I still remember that house that your ex-girlfriend had, that friend that we went over to that party one time.
Oh, yeah. And I remember on the east side. Yeah, like, I don't even know what neighborhood that is.
And our one buddy is a real estate agent. And he's like, he comes up to me. He's like, you know what this is? I'm like, yep. He's like, somebody put fucking $30,000 into this bitch and tried to sell it for $70,000 more. It was pretty funny.
That's funny.
Actually, they did a pretty good job, but
it's not bad.
I mean, for a first time. For a first house, like.
Oh, for sure. Well, by the time this debuts, we'll have the all-encompassing how to flip a home.
This is true.
Episode out, so you can go watch that and learn.
I probably would have already flipped a house by then, too.
Yeah. yeah, exactly. It's really easy to do. Zero money down. So, anyways, buy my $10,000 coaching program. So,
we should write an ebook.
I don't know how you guys haven't started one of those yet.
What?
That's a good internet business to start.
Ebook?
Ebooks?
No, coaching program. A couple grand.
I don't know. I guess I just have too much integrity and ethics in my business.
I was watching Gary Vee?
Yeah.
He just had a little snippet on, I think it was on Facebook I was watching it, but it was on passive income.
Yeah.
And he goes, passive income's a hoax. He says there's basically 3% of all passive income is actually passive income. Mm-hmm. The 3% being in the open markets, so stocks, if you get lucky. Or real estate. The rest, he's like, it's a bunch of douchebags trying to sell you $3,000 courses.
Super true, dude.
Very true.
Yeah.
Well, it's like whenever you hear, like, when they're doing a conference in Edmonton or whatever, and they'll bring on the radio ads, and it's like, hi, I'm so-and-so from some fucking TV show. If you're an elite investor in the Edmonton area, come down to the whatever community hall.
Tickets are always free.
Yeah, tickets are
always free.
Then they sell you $1,000 tickets to the next weekend.
I've been to one of those. You know how much a program cost?
How much?
So it was a program on how to flip homes, and they started in the U.S. So
there's a guy's named Robert Kiyosaki.
No, it wasn't. I forget what the guy speaking. The guy speaking, I think, was an ex and NFL player. I don't know. They were from the U.S. So the market there is way different than here.
Yeah, for sure.
And $50,000 for this program. I'm like, are you kidding me?
So, like, when you went to the free seminar, did they teach you anything valuable? Or was it just...
No, it was a bunch of, like, high energy, like, to basically get you to buy it. Like,
which if is you're what in, all those fucking
Yeah, if you're are, a right? decently intelligent person, you're going to see right through it. But 5-10% of the crowd is going to buy it.
Predatory, right, frankly?
Oh, it is.
And then I remember one realtor we used to work with telling me that he had clients who were, like, looking to invest, and he was like, they're like, oh yeah, we went to this seminar, and he's like, okay, whatever you do, don't buy anything. Like, maybe learn something, but like, don't.
Yeah.
And then, you know, he talks to them, and they like bought the coaching program, and they're like, yeah, it's cost $50,000, but we have no more down payment anymore.
So they couldn't he's like, where
the hell is your down payment? And then they're like, oh, but they said we can make it back in 3 months. And it's like, yeah, but you need money to buy the first house, right?
Oh, so, yeah.
Well, the thing, too, is in the States, if you have, like, well, even to put finance, like, if you were to finance a deal, like, excuse me, let's call it privately, like, just get people together, get their money, purchase, like, a home.
Yeah.
like, to get 10 people with 10 grand or whatever, like, that's not a crazy task.
No, if
right?
you, like, because so, if like a home's 100 grand or for whatever, the average so. Person, it might be a little difficult.
Yeah.
If you can, I don't want to say con, but convince.
Convince.
Like, it depends who you are.
Well, it depends.
If you have a financial background or you have a proven track record, yeah, it's going to be really simple. Yeah, but to get it for, like, your first one, it's probably going to be difficult. Oh,
yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
But you can also, I'm assuming in the States, you can do 5% down. I think you can even do 3% down on certain homes.
I thought there was times where you could put even less, but I think they got rid of that.
I know there is a government subsubsidized program where it's like 2.5% or 3%.
Well, I mean, but like, here you can get a line of credit, and that's your down payment, so it's kind of greasy. But that's my understanding. You guys,
probably know but that more. It's that screws up your affordability, right? So if you went, like, let's pretend you qualify for 400 at 5% down, to do 0% down, your qualification drops to like 300, 320.
Oh wow! So it's that high.
Yeah. Yeah, cause
which makes sense. It's like you can't
because they calculate grand. They calculate a payment on the line of credit as well,
which has a shorter amortization period probably
anyways. It's just 3% of the outstanding balance.
Oh, okay.
There's a little mortgage knowledge for you.
Hmm.
I mean, I consult your local licensed mortgage associate for to confirm,
because you're no longer licensed.
Yeah, no, I let it expire.
Yeah, so. Fair enough.
Yeah,
speaking of numbers, fucking accountant, so.
Yeah, exactly.
You just start throwing down fucking numbers.
Percentages at him, so, yeah.
ROI percentage, cap rates.
Yeah, but,
yeah.
What the fuck? But yeah, I mean, so in theory, like, in a lot of states, you can buy a home for, like your down payment is, like, $6,000-$7,000 or whatever.
Well,
like,
and so. People don't take into account the average price there is.
It's
25% like of what it is here. We're at right now. It's about $420 in the last month is the average price in Edmonton, and there's probably, I don't know,
you buy a 150? Fucking city in the States for that.
Yeah.
Remember when there was a like 30-story building in Detroit for sale for
I remember it was
like $600,000 or something like that. Yeah. I met someone who did real estate investing in the States, and he would buy in like Arizona, and actually did quite well, because you can buy a nice home for like $100-some-odd grand and rent it for like strangely comparable market rates to like.
I was just here. Gonna say that.
Really, like
your cap rate is weird. So much better.
It's bizarre.
Is it double digits?
Well, like
there's fuck for
you can buy homes for like $100-some-odd grand and rent them for like $1,200-1,300.
I was gonna say there are firms that are shooting for like between 15% and 20%.
Multifamily.
Yeah, annual return. Like, and that's not oat to lunch. Like, that's pretty safe investment.
Well, I remember we looked at, like, it was a 100-unit building. It was $4 million.
Yeah.
That would be...
In the States.
In the States. Here, that would be 12. Potentially 12 to 16.
Depends on a shitty one.
Like, no, it was pretty nice. Like, it wasn't like a high rise. It was a four-story walk-up. But it was newer. It was definitely...
Built. And it was 100 units?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be, like... Well, like $10 million, like $100,000 a door, right? So, how's my math?
Yeah.
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 Shitty.
Well,
these weren't 100 grand.
Yeah, but four-story walk-ups is like 100 and change per door. Is
they were nicer than the walk-ups here, though.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, that's U.S. too, so.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, but I mean, still.
Yeah.
The rent you're going to get for that unit is still going to be like $1,100
U.S. The point being, so this guy knew someone who... And, like, this guy would buy in Arizona, and he had a good relationship with his agent, and, like, he knew the place. But he was also like, I will not buy a place without flying down, seeing it in person.
Okay.
And then he knew someone who, like, tried to do that, and then saw this, like, schnazzy condo in Detroit, but it was all, like, 3D mock-ups and stuff. And they're like, oh, yeah, you can make X percent on it or whatever, which in theory you could if it was, like, maintained and blah, blah, blah. Buys it, like, it's remotely, like, it's as a foreign investor. Yeah, and then it was... No. It was a condo. Like, it existed. But when he went to it, like, the building was boarded up. There were, like, squatters in his unit and stuff. It was, like, something from a cartoon where, like, you know, camera shows this way. You're holding up a picture of the beautiful 3D renderings. You pull it down, and it's, like, post-apocalyptic. So, yeah. So, anyways, he gave me the advice of don't buy property without seeing it in person.
Don't buy in Detroit. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's like... You can get like $400 a month in Detroit for rent. So.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, and I'll also get shot.
This is true. That's Chicago. But, yeah.
I mean, you can get shot in a lot of places. You know, I was actually having this... I don't know. I don't really want to take the conversation this way, but we were just talking as agents in our office where we're like, man, because, you know, they talk about realtor safety and you're meeting strangers at all around the city and whatever,
yeah.
and
yeah.
kind of isolated. And it's like, could you imagine having to worry about that person also maybe having a gun? Like, that would just be, I don't know.
You know
crazy.
What you know what, dude?
Carry around.
Take steroids.
Yeah, well, I explained that, Josh.
But you just got to be intimidating.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you know, just like you walk in there, they're not going to... If I shoot this guy, I'm going to have to shoot him like 5 times.
Oh, okay.
You know, yeah, like that's how you... once is not going to do it.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Honestly, you can keep talking, but... and we'll just, if you want, we can put video over it, so...
Oh, okay. Oh. Yeah.
Or like, just like a transition thing or whatever.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I do sick transitions, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, all you gotta do is drag the fucking clip over the other clip, and it does an auto-transition for you.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
It makes me look professional as fuck, dude.
Here, do you want to start converting this to the fucking...
Oh, does it only... There's only so much data on it?
Yeah, you can only record for 30 minutes, so that's
kind of... Oh, the card's not gonna run out of data. We just have two cards, because it allows me to, like... Because it takes a while to transfer the video over.
Excuse me.
So, yeah, we kind of almost got it down to a science. Close.
Yeah, we're getting... more scientific with it, so
yeah, we're getting there.
Cool. Was that just put? Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then yeah, because like I do the audio. What I've started doing is like more of a very Joe Rogan-esque with the intro. Oh fuck, that's gonna be really loud. I'll let you fire that up before I start
recording again.
But like where I kind of sit there and just talk, like just me and Meg. So we talked, we had so-and-so, we talked about this, or like me and Josh will do it together, but in the future. But like rather than be like...
Do you want me to keep raw footage or nah?
Like in the drive?
No, like, you know, like I have the videos from last week. Should I keep that or...
I don't care. No. if it's up, it doesn't matter, so...
Jesus.
I will just delete them then.
It's easy. Yeah, I probably would too.
Hey, DCI.
How big's a file?
30 minutes is usually about 2 gigs.
That's not bad.
It's not... They're not huge. Like, it's also not shooting 4K. But I think it's maybe 720p.
It says it's 1080 on YouTube when we upload it.
Oh, wow. Look at the service here.
I'm holy okay. Shit, thank you. Because I actually will fucking... drive off the road.
You feeling it?
No, I'm fine. I can get another.
Yeah, there's a lot in there. But you know what? I'll keep it over here, and you just decide what you want to do with it. So
sounds good, dude. Then actually, that opening banter was pretty good.
Yeah, but we might just have a weird...
just like... just you have me say it, and then a...
Just have like... just go like... Ooh,
no, just them. Over this, like, don't, when it's
just their own.
Don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
You know what? I can say what I want to say. Back to it?
Yeah.
Man, who the fuck is texting you?
They're not phones are silent.
Dick.
Is that fake?
You know what, dude?
All right, so,
yeah, you know what? I set a fucking notification halfway through the show. Make it look like I'm fucking popular.
Yeah, exactly.
No, it's our guest for tomorrow confirming, yeah, bro. Oh, good. You know what? I'm doing my fucking job. Okay. That's what I'm doing. God damn it.
Are you on your phone? Yeah, I just texted, get me the fuck out of here to, like, so many people.
So, fuck, man.
Anyways, welcome to the last episode ever of Long and Hard, because Josh trimmed his beard, and,
dude, I didn't even recognize myself today. Like, I get the haircut,
yeah,
and I'm looking in the mirror, I'm like, this is a different fucking person.
Yeah.
Did you
get the beard cut at the same time?
No, I did that myself. You know what I did, sorry, dude? I was trying to shape it, and then I just kind of nicked it, and I was like, time to cut it, whatever. And...
what, your beard?
Yeah, and I just did, like, a three, and then
why
all
can't
of a sudden,
you...
like, just, you know what, even dude? Out the... You know what? I was sick of getting girls. So I was like, you can have them all.
Yeah, exactly.
There so, you go.
Beard not going anywhere. Thanks, Josh.
Hey, you're very welcome.
Looking
dude.
Out for all dude, the bearded guys
I am
in Edmonton.
I'm a charity.
Yeah, Dylan, is there a tax deductible expense for that? Or
no.
You know what I've done before
Goodwill?
With you, Dylan?
What?
Is inadvertently, I've written off some dates that didn't go anywhere. And you helped me do that, so
What are you talking about?
I'm just giving a fuck with you.
Yeah. Same.
Did I send you that Instagram post that one time? It was like a Wall Street thing, and it was like, it's a guy who's like expensing this date that ghosted on him.
I've seen that.
No, I haven't seen that.
I'm pretty sure I sent it to you.
I think he's trying to. No, he's trying to expense it.
That's exactly what he's trying to do. He's trying to expense the date because she ghosted or something. I thought it was pretty funny.
Business meeting.
Was it like a text or something? Or was it just like...
No, it had him in his like accounting software. And it was he was putting like $100 for like a steak dinner as like she ghosted.
As the notes?
And, yeah. And he put the like charity it was going to was like Ghosts United.
There you go.
It's
pretty funny. Yeah, that is funny.
Yeah. That's what happens.
Ghost United.
That's what happens when you go on online.
Honestly,
dating
we should start a charity that is a real charity.
Yep.
And that's you somehow. Oh wait, would this be fraud? Where you can like
write
your donations under that?
Sorry. Then, what do you want to do?
Well, have like a real charity for people who get ghosted on, and somehow you can.
Yeah, but you have to get registered status, and that's not.
Yeah, but
no,
I mean, you could like.
No.
Where's the money go?
Argue equality, right?
Where's the money go?
Do
you buy lottery tickets with it?
600x return on income. Or, yeah.
Dude, that'd be a sick fund.
What are donation schemes? Do you guys know what those are?
No.
Tell it.
Educate the people of Edmonton.
Yeah.
In the mid-2000s, there were
CPA.
These schemes that people would donate this piece of art, and it would be like, you know, you go to HomeSense.
Sorry, go on.
And buy like a $100 piece of art, and then the charity would value it
at like $100,000.
Sure, yeah, okay. And then they give you a donation receipt for $100,000, because when you donate like a good to a charity, it's at fair market value.
I think that still goes on today because you can just donate pieces of artwork to like certain places.
No, but these charities were known. They were set up so they would inflate the value.
But I also think that like does go on now. Like in that you have a piece of art and because you can't tangibly evaluate it.
Yeah, but it's 10 times. Like it's subjective, right? So
I guess, but I mean.
But it's subjective to a point, but if you take a bunch of appraisers in, they're going to come pretty close.
I don't know, man. This Wayne's World box here?
Yeah.
$50,000.
Oh.
Yeah.
I donated it to you.
Thank you.
Write that shit off.
So, could I just become like a weird abstract artist and say my paintings are worth $100,000?
You're already a weird abstract artist.
Yeah, exactly, right?
Look at your fucking mustache, Salvador Dali over here.
Yeah, I need a little more twirl to the end of these.
You need some length to it.
Yeah, I mean, but then I can just donate stuff to you. Or sorry, not to you, but like donate my crappy art.
To the charity.
And then, yeah. This is brilliant. Thanks, Dylan.
You're welcome.
So Dylan can be reached at 780 for all your tax evasion needs. I mean...
tax evasion is the bad one, right?
Yeah.
And tax...
Avoidance.
Avoidance is the good one.
That's like, correct, yeah.
Not good one.
Avoidance, you're not going to get in too much trouble.
Yeah.
You might have to pay some taxes and penalties,
right.
But...
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's not a word that you would use...
Most people would consider most of it tax evasion, but there is a legal difference between the two.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah for sure.
Yeah, I failed all my accounting classes. So.
So, we had a weird little blip in our audio there, but C's get degrees, I think, is what we were saying.
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
You know, it's a very freeing thing when you're, like, fourth year university, and you're, like, you know, you were grinding it out, and then you're, like, especially if you're going the self-employed route, like... This mostly applies to you and I, so maybe don't listen to this, kids, but where you're like, I'm not going to use this fucking degree anyways.
You know what, man? I looked at my own degree when I hired myself, so.
You know what you do?
I almost fired myself.
Then I was like, you didn't do so good in, you know,
interpretive dance.
Yeah.
Basket weaving 101.
Interpretive dance, yeah.
What are you gonna say?
Oh, you just line up a job in third year, you do well, and then you get your job offer,
sure.
And you just fuck off.
Yeah. Well, you know what I was reading today is there's some book by Dave Asprey, who was like the founder of that Bulletproof
Coffee
company and all that.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Anyway, in his book, he was talking about like really applying himself in school to the things that he liked, and then just kind of like coasting on the things that he didn't like. And he's like, dude, at the end of the day, we all ended up in the same place. We all graduated. nobody's going to fucking care that I didn't do well in this one class, mm-hmm. but I did exceptionally well in the classes that I actually did care about.
Yeah.
So.
Huh. Who was that again?
Dave Asprey.
Dave Asprey.
Yeah.
That guy's nuts. Have you seen what he does? He's like body hacking?
Yeah. I was actually watching a video the other day and he was talking about like doing like fucking microdosing LSD and stuff, and that's why I was looking into it. So.
Like microdosing LSD, like in, have you guys ever seen, is it Princess Bride or whatever? Where?
No, that's the one with the fucking Dread Pirate Robbers.
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about the fucking poison.
Yeah, where the poison scene. You know what I'm talking about? Where it's like, you know, he's like, which poison do you drink? And then he dies. And he's like, well, I drank a little poison every day.
Yeah.
So can that guy go to like crazy parties and just like
drop a tab of acid
and just be normal?
I don't know, man. There's actually like a huge. He says in the book.
Why did he microdose for it?
Like, well, he says in the book.
What's that to accomplish?
He says in the book that it's like almost mainstream that people are microdosing LSD. I'm like, dude, you must be living in like the heart of Silicon Valley.
Yeah.
For that to be mainstream. But at the end of the day, people seem to have, like, they don't get the high, but they have like the clarity benefits.
Oh,
like,
okay. Kind of the creative or whatever.
Yeah, exactly. So like Steve Jobs talked about doing LSD all the time.
I know some people microdose mushrooms, and I think that's for pain management though.
Yeah, psilocybin?
I think they put
tea in the morning and they have a little bit.
Same shit.
Yeah.
Same shit, dude. Yeah. So you like take these like brain drugs, nootropics, mm-hmm. I guess.
Yeah.
And you have a better life.
Hmm.
So, not advocating this, looking directly at the camera, but at the same time.
Drugs are bad. Yeah. Drugs are bad, okay?
Yeah. Stay in school.
Maybe. Or don't.
Do what you want to do.
Degrees don't matter anymore, so...
Yeah. We were having that huge... Do you remember that discussion we were having with our group chat?
Yeah.
About the degrees mattering? And, like, the degrees not mattering?
I'm assuming it was between someone that has almost a doctor.
Yeah.
We'll
probably have him on the show.
So. Oh, yeah. Let's say this. It was the more highly educated guys versus Josh and Thomas, who are very, like,
high school
self-starter.
I wasn't part of this. I was on the sidelines.
I believe you, like, joined, like, many hours later after the argument had been had.
Sometimes we have, like, these huge discussions while everybody's supposed to be at work.
That's what I think about, too. It's, like... 11 a.m.
Yeah. See, I gotta pick and choose who I text, and sometimes you guys talking, especially when our friend in Ottawa, Adam, brings in the most random facts. I'm like, man, I don't have time to banter with you about this shit.
Dude, I stopped
reading. I don't have time at 7 p.m. to do this.
I stopped reading the news because of him.
You don't have to. He's like a
news source, dude.
Yeah.
He's like fucking CBC, fucking BBC.
He's like a garburator. He's a news garburator.
Yeah, so he just like comes
that
out.
That is
like
the worst when you jump in everything. Any group chat, though.
Yeah.
And you're like 10 messages behind.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, fuck it. I'm not part of this conversation.
I'm part of a big group chat that I'm like 1,000 messages behind. I'm never going to.
Is it your like staff? Like, who is it?
No, like a forum.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
And I'm just like never going to catch up.
Nah. Yeah.
Absolutely not.
Yeah. The worst is when someone like makes a group chat for like a party or event or something, and they're like, "Okay, everyone, come at 10 or whatever the fuck," and then someone will like randomly post something, and then it just explodes.
Yes.
Good story. Mm-hmm. So
that sucks. Yeah, that's a downer.
Yeah, it is a downer.
Yeah.
Like having a huge fucking party at Lynnwood McDonald's.
Yeah, exactly. R.I.P.
Were you invited to that?
Yeah, I know, and it's cops came.
Do you, see that it's torn down?
Oh, yeah. I drove by. That's how I got here.
That was... literally, the day after Josh came home, we were going downtown for something. And I'm, like, in the middle of talking about something seriously. And then we're going down 87th Ave. And then he just cuts me off and he's like, what the fuck happened here? Because Lynnwood McDonald's was leveled.
Yeah, man, straight like, leveled.
It's just dirt.
And I was like... What? Could they come home?
R.I.P.
They're rebuilding.
Yeah, I know.
They're bigger and better.
Is it gonna be like?
That's why they.
That one's been so old. They also tore down the commercial stuff.
Because like, they owned it all.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
so McDonald's Corporation owns it all. The dentist office. That's actually where I used to go.
Yeah.
they moved to Lewis Estate. So like none of those businesses are coming back. It's going to be it's like McDonald's head office is what I was
told. Oh, it's going to be an Uber McDonald's.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Shit, man.
With like two floors, like the ones in New York.
Speaking of McDonald's, I got robbed when I was in Montreal.
Oh, yeah.
This guy came.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, your food at McDonald's.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
We knew it was going to happen. Yeah. It was like watching.
Yeah, this drunk
in slow motion.
Yeah. Pretty much.
We like both look at each other. We're like, is this guy seriously going to do this?
Yeah, and he did it.
What was the guy like?
He was probably 5'6".
You know what? Explain the story.
So I've never used those machines at McDonald's before. I've always just gone over the counter and had a fucking conversation to order my food, right? But everybody's so like antisocial nowadays, they have these machines that you order on, right?
I believe it's due to the cost of labor and not antisocial.
They still have the people working in the back, man.
Yeah,
they're still there.
They can't have machines that put the cheeseburgers together properly.
Not yet.
Anyway.
Sorry, I interrupted.
Automation. Anyway. This is the fucking, like, this is a point against automation, dude. You get robbed from it.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I didn't know you take your receipt from the machine.
Yeah.
I didn't even want a receipt. Paper.
Okay.
So the guy comes in behind me and he's like, buy me a Big Mac. And he's fucking two sheets to win, man. And I'm like, no.
No.
So I walk away and he takes my receipt out of the thing, right? And my order comes up.
You literally got outsmarted by like a drunk homeless man.
This is true. Yeah, I did.
So, and then he's just like, yeah, order 6969.
Yeah, he's got the receipt.
He's got the receipt, dude. So he takes the bag and just walks out of there. And I just like turn to the girl. I'm like, yeah, that was my order. And she's like, oh, we'll just make you another one. It's like, thanks. Yeah, but fuck.
That's funny.
That's what I get for going to McDonald's. I haven't been to McDonald's in 5 years, and then that happened. So,
Mr. Holier than thou over here.
Yeah, dude, I'm fit as fuck.
Fit as fuck.
Fasting for 22 hours.
Yeah. Thanks. How's that holding up for you right now?
It's great, dude. You can see better.
Can you?
I can see through you.
I can see your aura around you.
You can see the energy.
Yeah, that I gives can you see your energies.
You need to check that, bro.
You got a lot of purple and yellow around you. That means...
Yeah. It means you're Wario.
Remember...
Fucking Mario Bros.
Remember the Dane Cook bit about... it was about interpreting your dreams?
Okay.
And it's like... Do you remember that? No?
No.
Do you?
No, I don't.
Oh. Well... Then I won't recant it because I'll probably butcher it. But it was, I don't know. It was
like how bad I butchered that fucking Marcus Aurelius quote last week.
Oh, yeah.
That was
well,
so
as
bad.
I was like reading it, I think I reread part of the words because it made no sense. But I don't know. The point's there. So.
Yeah, the point is there.
Yeah. Anyway, there's a Dane Cook bit about like if there's a giant crab chasing you in your dreams, it means something. I don't know. It'd be funnier if you got the reference. But
butchered it.
Yeah. Well, one of the lines is like he's talking to his friends about it, and it's like, wait, was the crab wearing loafers? And he's like, yeah, he was. And then it's like, anyways, it's probably not the most appropriate joke.
So. Butchered it.
Yeah, I might just cut this section here. My computer keeps fucking locking. Okay.
You know what, man?
What?
I don't like this video editing software.
Why?
Because we used to do our podcasts heart to heart. No editing involved. Couldn't cut shit.
Yeah.
And now you're going to try and cut that?
A couple things you're going to cut in here.
Yeah.
Maybe just... We'll just do, like, you know... Remember the, like, TV thing when, like, it lost a signal and it would be, like, the different colors?
Oh, yeah. Be, like, the rainbow.
Yeah, the sound effect for that. Mr. Audio Guy, you find me that.
Yeah, what was the sound effect? Oh, yeah. Maybe I'll just use that. Loop it. Honestly, I'd probably rather do that.
Fuck, so. I fell into that one.
We should take it as like a video clip. And it's just you like two in the face. So it's like just loops over and over again.
Fuck.
Sorry, we're having technical difficulties.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
This hat is for you, by the way.
Thank you. You
know, size, how, oh, size I was wondering what that was for.
You know how often I wear hats?
Just put this on and see what happens.
We'll see. Yeah. Front? Oh, I got a big noggin. Big the, brain here.
Yeah. Big brain fuck. Gang.
Yeah.
This the hat doesn't even fit this guy.
Really?
Yeah. He tries putting it on his head.
Lowly, small brain Josh.
You know what, dude? All the smartest people I know.
How do you wear a hat? You wear one like it's like barely on like this, don't you?
What am I, 14?
Yeah. Am I 17 years old? Is it?
Back?
I don't know.
A little puff coming out?
Yeah, there you go.
There we go.
Yeah. Nice. The Jimmy Neutron.
Yeah.
Do you have a... Oh, wait. This will be...
You want to go to a thrift shop this weekend like this?
Yeah, dude.
It's where it's happening
You can start buy, like pawning shit off.
No, that's oh, like literally
you
a
You mean
bar.
The bar?
It's called Thrift Shop.
Oh, is that the one? It used to be something else.
You don't have to wear it.
Denizen?
Just giving it
Denizen.
To
Thank
yeah,
you.
Denizen. Denizen. Yeah. I never actually
I heard it. It's a happening spot. It's what the new word on the street is.
I've heard.
Actually, I think I did hear that, which is kind of unsuspecting, but I think that is like a place to go.
I think it's quite young, but I was told that by my cousin. So.
All right. Well, I mean, we can give her a go.
All right. So, we'll report back on how Thrift Shop went. I think their shtick is that everything's for sale or something like that in the place.
This is fucking awesome.
Is that on a repeat?
Yeah, exactly. I wow. expect no other songs.
Yeah. Yeah,
no shit.
Go there, we'll request it a couple times.
Yeah. Honestly.
Man, there's not very many places to go in Edmonton. There's like...
It's a real. Well, after going to Montreal, it's very different.
Yeah.
So, what would you say Montreal is like the vibes of places?
Or
is
there
okay,
more
and
bars?
I'll explain it because he's like, he loves, he has got a hard on for Montreal.
Like, everything sucks except Montreal.
I'm,
so, yeah.
I'm somewhat biased for you, I guess. So,
all right. Sounds good.
I've been like in Europe out, but like usually it's like the main nightclub. So, it's hard to say, but we went out like, what, 3-4 times?
Yeah, you and I went out
yeah.
4 times.
Our other friend slept in his bed because he's lame-o, but...
Yeah, so...
It's an older... Like, they have more lounge-esque type bars for an older crowd.
Yeah.
Like, the ones Josh and I went to, we were probably one of the, some of the younger people in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which is better than a bunch of drunk 18-year-olds. Not that I don't enjoy that once in a while, but, you know, that gets old and it's kind of hard to see.
But in that...
Edmonton's predominantly that, in my opinion.
Like right, and then, so those lounges, do you, like, interact with people? Or
yeah,
is it, like,
so
is like
we went to this
like
one, yeah,
the
we
lounge
went,
in a restaurant, right?
No, so we went to this one lounge. It's in an old mansion in downtown Montreal.
Oh, okay.
It's in a hotel.
Yeah.
But it's all, like, dark mahogany wood, but the music is, they play, like, not top 40-ish, kind of, like, more electronic-esque like... music. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's upbeat. It is kind of loud in there. You still can have a conversation. It's not too loud. And everyone's dressed, you know, very well.
Yeah, nicer. Wearing suits and shit.
Yeah, like if you don't have a, you know, dress
collared
pants.
Shirt or
yeah,
something.
Even with that, like if you don't have a jacket on, you're probably underdressed. But it's more the 25 to, I'd say, 30 crowd and probably people that are doing better for themselves.
Okay.
Like, yeah. I'd say it's more white collar, probably.
Yeah, okay.
You'd see that? Yeah,
for sure, for sure.
That was cool. There's a few other ones, like on top of buildings, there's, you know, nice, like, bars. And
yeah.
And then we did we went to an 18-year-old bar. Which was, like, pretty equivalent to what we
what
have
in
here.
Isn't it 19 in Quebec, or is Quebec 18?
It's
actually, 18, Quebec's 18 as well.
Yeah.
18. Yeah.
We went to, like, a nightclub, the big one. La Rouge is what it was called.
La Rouge, yeah.
Yeah. Big line out front. Walked right in.
Yeah, dude.
Because you're just looking sleek or what?
Yeah, you know it.
Or did you, was it with your friend?
Who Honestly, man, I was wearing my fucking shades. Guy didn't want to argue with me.
Nice.
He's wearing his shades out, and it's... 11 p.m.
Yeah.
We have to let him in. No. We knew the bartender.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay, okay. Cool. So, huh. Yeah. Interesting.
Josh had
so,
a
yeah,
night.
So I guess... What's that?
We don't talk about that.
Yeah.
But comparably, it's more... You have more options there.
Yeah.
And there's also, like, 5 white halves.
Yeah. We have lounges here, but they just never take off because I don't think there's enough clientele for them. Or the people don't want to... It, I mean, it's going to cost more money if you want to drink there. It's double the price, at least, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, there's lounges here, but they're all...
It's a little different.
There's sort of... It's like 50-plus at these lounges in Edmonton.
Yeah.
It's hard
yeah,
to... There's yeah. no, like, happening... Or there's less happening places for, I'd say, like, the mid, like, 25 to 35.
Young professionals.
Guys. Yeah.
Yeah.
Who I don't want to, you know, be partying with someone who's looking for a fight or something like that. That's just not...
dude, right, you I see where you're getting always at. Looking for a fight.
Yeah,
exactly. I'm 20-0.
You're 20-0.
KOs, baby.
Were you wearing ripped jeans the other day?
No. Maybe.
You're fucking fighting in them or something. Fucking fashion guy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Classic.
Yeah, he's probably one of the best dressed people I know, so.
Yeah.
7 out of 10.
Yeah.
7
out
of 10?
I'll give myself 7 out of 10. Okay.
I mean, but, you didn't really fucking give us much to talk about today. Yeah,
exactly. Geez, still.
No, I'm sorry, guys.
Look, you know, jogger pants or whatever. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's going to the gym after this, is what he's doing. Okay, so. Yeah.
Nah, not if we do a full 3 hours.
Speaking of fashion guy, motherfucker leaves two jackets in Montreal for me.
like sport coats? Like suit jackets?
Like one's like a... They're like...
I don't know, like...
One's what, suede?
Yeah, like you would...
And then like a kind of leather
casual,
one.
But...
Not semi
above casual.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice jackets.
Yeah.
But like not suit jackets. Like more like that, like a bomber sort of thing or something.
Yeah. Yeah, but like okay. Yeah.
So he's like, mail me them.
Did you just forget them or what?
Yeah, they're hanging up in the closet. And oh, I didn't okay. Grab them when I left.
Mail me them.
Mail me them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I should have charged you way more. Should charge you like
at a premium.
I probably should ask you. I probably should ask this guy for the receipt.
Yeah, should have invoiced like, all right, shipping costs $75. You know, labor.
I made a whole fucking 23 cents off of you.
Labor.
So suck my cock.
Labor. $200 an hour.
This guy was late. It took 2 weeks to get here because he was going to the doctor so much.
All right, we need to pause, actually, so that's a good time to stop this conversation. Okay. Like, they actually get really good engagements. It's like 25%.
Oh, yeah.
So, but yeah, because it's just the exterior shot is kind of tricky, right? Because, like, this one...
Did you get your Instagram story?
Oh, no, I didn't.
Go right, take it. Go take it.
But anyways, because there's no garage and unfinished basement, so.
Yeah.
It's spruce, so spruce is a touch cheaper, right?
Look at this guy on his phone on our shelf.
Sorry, yeah. This house I was going to go see tomorrow went pending.
What?
Some house I was going to go see tomorrow went pending.
Oh. Well, get off your fucking phone on the show, bro.
Florence is a good picture because you're just looking at him like, what the fuck are you doing?
Let's see this. That's a good cover photo, bro. It's a cover photo for the ages.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
I'd go on it, but I don't have your fucking Wi-Fi and there's no service down here.
Yeah, I know. He's terrible at giving me the Wi-Fi.
Do you have it?
Trying to keep the guests undistracted. So, distracted.
Which one are you?
Which one am I?
Shaw?
Yeah.
Yeah, use
the Shaw. Send... Share it with me.
I don't know how.
Just open your phone.
I'll just send you the picture that he sent me.
Yeah.
If you go, go to your phone.
Yeah.
Is it on? It should ask you to share a password. No.
It shows them the screen. No, there's like an actual, like you go into the settings, I think, isn't it?
No, it usually just pops up.
Oh, okay.
Really?
Yeah.
I do have my phone on sleep, so.
Wow. Oh. I didn't know this technology existed, bro. Here, give me your phone. Just tap them. You remember the thing where they, like, tap them and you give, like, contact information? That's so cool. Why don't they do that anymore?
Are you Shaw?
Yeah.
Which one? 5G or the other one?
The other one.
The class that I did just
no, his. Oh, it's, like, right there.
He's talking right into the mic.
Yeah.
Like, he's got a fucking voiceover.
Should we put it on the close setting so we all have to sit?
Yeah, we could just sit like this around the mic.
Fuck.
Did you get it?
No.
All right. Don't lean on the table, bro.
It's not on. Oh, it is on.
Yeah,
we're actually recording right
now. Yeah, so
this is actually going to be amazing.
Man.
Okay, do you remember that thing where you could actually, like, tap the fucking phones together?
Yeah.
Do you remember that?
But that was a different brand. Like, who was that?
Samsung?
Maybe? I think so. I think that's Samsung.
Samsung's always miles ahead, dude.
But, like, Koreans. I don't know. Like, that's something that's almost like... Oh, for fuck's sake, Dylan, what did he do here? Okay.
No, you know what, man? I would use it all the time.
You know, well, I mean, I guess AirDrop is kind of...
You know? There you go.
AirDrop is kind of the same.
You know, right? They're doing the fucking... You can do the charge thing now, too.
Wait, isn't that a Huawei thing?
No, it's Samsung.
What do you mean a charge thing?
So, like, if you have wireless charging on your phone, you can put your phone on my phone, and it'll charge.
But...
Oh.
Yeah, so,
but
like,
who gets the charge, I guess?
The lower battery.
Oh, okay.
It's Huawei, not rocket science, bro.
No, but Huawei had something like that.
Yeah, but I would never get a Huawei phone.
Yeah, yeah, obviously not. But, like, I remember, basically, what you guys just did, they had a commercial where two people go in, like, basically, like, hand hug.
It's a nice way to meet people, dude.
I guess.
You know what? We live in a society where it's very difficult to meet people.
But I guess AirDrops...
And you're trashing on this.
AirDrops kind of...
You're just shitting on this.
AirDrops kind of a good, similar idea, is it not, to
you're
that?
You're trying to build connections, and you're shitting on this, bro. Just shitting on it.
But, yeah. Fuck interacting with people. Yeah. But, oh, Christ. AirDrops kind of the same idea. But I don't know, I feel like the kind of cutesiness of, like, bumping your phones to, like, share contact info. I don't know. There's almost features that are, like, too practical in that people don't actually use them, if that makes sense. Like, it's annoying. Like, there's a lot of capabilities your phone has that, like, you might not even know how to do. Or
I got, like,
never
a younger
use.
Friend at work.
Yeah.
Or, I guess, colleague. And they show me how to do shit on my phone all the time. I'm like, am I this old?
Oh, yeah.
There's so many things that you have no idea what you're doing.
But there's also things that you just don't need
to do. No, I know. Like,
it's like, I'm going to figure out... I don't know. What do they teach you how to do?
That was a very good beer pass. It was very, like...
You could have thrown it.
Oh, okay, a good one. You know when you get a, you're like reading a group chat in iMessage?
Okay.
And a new one comes in and it goes down automatically. I didn't know if you tap the top twice, it goes back to where you were.
Where is the top? Like, in the name? Or, like, just top of the message?
Yeah, here, I'll show you. Yeah.
This is good for our audience because we're all old 25-year-olds that aren't going to know how to
do it. Wait, I don't know how to do it anymore.
That is the worst, actually, that it does that and it, like, jumps down. Going back to the earlier thing of...
Go back and reread it.
Yeah, but then when, the, like, the group chat's popping off and you're, like, 10 messages behind...
I just throw it in airplane mode.
And that's when you're, like, fuck.
Have no friends.
Yeah. See your solution.
There you go. Just stop having friends.
Yeah. How's the beer going down with your fasting there, Josh?
Feel great. You guys want to go out tonight?
Sure. What, Monday? Oh,
was it Monday?
Yeah.
Where to go on a Monday? Instagram live. answer the question.
Comment. Fucking.
Oh, probably some place. I don't know. It's like industry people Hudson's. Who go out on weeknights. Yeah, something like
that. I have gone out on a Monday once.
How did that go?
Yeah, tell us about it.
Industry night party.
Oh,
Expert, yeah. I don't work in the industry.
Yeah.
But I was there.
Yeah. I got invited this year, actually.
I'm did, like, you?
I mean, you know, it's kind of tempting, but it's, like, also a goddamn Monday night, right? So
I had a test the next day.
Yeah.
Super hungover. Couldn't even walk across the street when my brother came to pick me up. It was like, come here.
No, you come to me.
Is it the parking lot across the street from the place? No, bro, too far.
I don't know, they had it at Anthem, which looks kind of crazy, and they're like, they totally redid that place.
Is that
Knox Oil City? Okay. Or,
yeah, to us and to most of our audience,
is that
Oil City? Yes.
Yeah, it's Oil City, bro.
Yeah.
Why don't they just bring back Oil City?
Yeah. Oh, you know what you should do? Make Oil City in the ranch. And then that will be the golden...
Oh, it's like the Bermuda Triangle.
Yeah.
Or dude, that would be Bermuda one.
Line.
The Bermuda point.
Point.
The Bermuda point.
No, Triangle. Yes. Whiskey Jack's, Oil City, Ranch.
Okay, yeah.
So you bring back Threesome Thursdays.
I was about to say, so Thursdays.
I'm really happy all of our listeners are like Albertans.
Yeah, Albertans and roughly our age, so we know what bars that we're talking about. So
they're also like, these guys are hicks.
Yeah.
Just straight up rednecks.
Yeah. Okay, so anyways, seeking financing for Edmonton nightclub theme will be...
Should just literally open a place called the Bermuda Triangle.
Ooh, that's what this place should be called. Use the picture from How I Met Your Brother, where it's like, we should open a bar or whatever. Remember that episode?
Oh, God.
What's the legal minimum you can sell drinks for? $2.25?
don't know.
There is.
You get a rack of Jack in Montreal for $12.
You can get a what? A rack of Jack for
$12.
Four shots?
Six shots.
Is it six?
So it must be $2.
Oh, are you saying rack of Jack?
Yeah, dude.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. So it must be $2 a shot.
It's provincially regulated.
Well, a lot of it is like it has to be a special.
Yeah. $1 drinks.
My campaign is $1 drinks.
For everybody.
Province wide. Probably got a lot of momentum on that campaign.
100%. Trail, in Alberta, you could too.
Oh, yeah.
There's nothing to do here but drink.
Okay, Mr. Montreal boner over there.
No, I was kidding. Yeah. There's mountains that you go to drink at.
They're nice. And for a beautiful hike this weekend.
Yeah, exactly.
Good for you, Mr. fucking outdoor guy.
Yeah, fucking idiot enjoying the outdoors.
I don't even go outside anymore, man.
Yeah.
We were having this discussion before. I was like, I just take D-tabs.
What?
I just take D-tabs.
What's that?
Vitamin D.
Oh.
Jesus
Christ. Just any drugs.
Have to like wrap us.
Sometimes you just look at this guy, eh?
I assume that was like a more interesting answer than just, nah, I just eliminated the need to actually go outside.
There's this thing called context, bro.
Yeah.
So I don't go outside, so I take the D tabs.
Yeah.
Context.
Wouldn't you call it, are they tabs though?
I don't know.
Who called
they? Pills.
Pills.
Pills. Yeah. You're the wrong one in this situation, so.
No, I'm not. I'll stand D-tabs. By it.
I mean, I like that. Like, now you never have to go outside again.
Exactly.
Can maximize time coding.
Burn your eyes out on the screen instead of the sun, dude.
Oh, God.
Qui-Gon Jinn, eh?
Yeah, those are a nice little piece to the studio. You,
are those new?
No,
are those new?
Dude, I thought maybe like you had them in your room and some girl came in and was like,
are those new?
No, I didn't mean like that. I meant, were they in your room before and someone might have made a little fun of you?
No. So I got that. So I got that in.
You probably had a Tinder date come over. She saw that. Was like, how fucking old is this guy?
It says 20 on your profile.
No, you get, or yeah, have use the plus one where it blocks your age or whatever.
But how do you show up in their, what if their search settings are like 18 or 24?
You still show
you
up.
You show up, but it doesn't say what your age is.
Right. So you could be 50, dude.
I'm going to be honest.
No. It, like, I think it tells, like, in a backdoor way what your age is or something like that. Oh. I don't know. It's weird. I don't know. I wonder, follow-up research on if that dude in Amsterdam who wanted to reduce his age legally by 20 years. Did you guys hear about that?
Yes.
You and I talked about this.
Oh, I did. I saw the article. Yeah.
Anyways.
Pretty sure Dylan actually sent it. Could be wrong.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, maybe
might
it was
have,
you.
Might
yeah.
have sent it.
Yeah.
It was a while ago.
But yeah, for those who don't know, there was a dude in the Amsterdam, in the Netherlands, the Amsterdams, who, I want to say was like 67, or something like that, but felt he was being discriminated on dating apps due to his age. So
was
he wanted
dating apps.
Yeah, yeah.
No, it must have been something.
Or it was online dating. It was online.
Like if I put myself on a dating app, I'm probably gonna say I'm 2 years younger than I actually am.
It was specific to dating apps. Was the reason he cited, and he was. God damn it! And then, so he was 67, and he wanted to change his age to 47, so he could...
67, man, you're tapped out.
There's a word... No,
yeah,
there's one...
that's a little tricky at that point.
So. I don't know if it's Portugal, but it's somewhere in Europe. It's not like France or Italy, but it's a smaller one. And this guy, in their pension, if you're a woman, you get it at an earlier age. So he legally changed his sex to become
female. That's
what
I thought it was, dude.
Oh, okay. That's what I sent.
No. Yeah. The one... I must have sent it, because I think I wrote the caption, not all heroes wear capes. And it was because the guy on Tinder wanted his age to say younger.
Yeah, dude, 67, you're tapped out.
Yeah.
Half the people are dead by
that. For the record, the guy looked
pretty good
for his age.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah, he can look good at 67, man.
Yeah. So, going back to the fucking Star Wars figurines over there, so, they're not dolls, they're action figures. No, so the story is bobbleheads. So no, they like they're like animatronic, but they probably don't work anymore. Yeah. But like, so the Darth Maul one I got for like my 6th or 7th birthday, like whenever that movie actually came out. And then the next year I got the Qui-Gon Jinn one, and then they were just sitting around the house forever, right? And they're a set, and they like move together. And then my parents were at an antique show, like within the last 5 years sort of thing, and found the Obi-Wan one, so they wanted to have it. Because those two are just sitting down here forever, and then they wanted to have the whole set. Bro. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
You know, no one's ever quite called... It kind of just blends in with all the other memorabilia, I guess.
Dude, I'll call it out.
Yeah.
I will call it out.
Oh, I wish they worked. So, they were hilarious.
I will call it out.
But yeah, I just had the two for the longest time, and then got the other one, and yeah. The rest is...
No, I didn't see it, because I was sitting there last time.
Yeah, I guess you were just looking at this boring empty wall. Fucking wall. Now you can look at the cooler stuff over there.
Yeah. I like our studio, Dylan.
It's good. It's nice.
Dylan, what do you think of the studio?
It's very eclectic in here.
Yeah, you feel kind of like you're going back a couple years.
Eclectic? Yeah. How so? Like,
it's a bunch of random items. You got sports, drums, dolls.
Foosball. Fucking air hockey.
Yeah.
Some Banff license plate. Got your Australian influence in there with the boomerang.
Yeah.
What else you got in here? Telephone from like 1900s?
Or it just looks like one. Like it's actually a normal one.
Some Jofa gloves? Jofa. That's a fucking blast from the past.
Oh, okay.
Oh, he looked up the definition of eclectic.
I don't really know the word, the definition.
I see what he's doing. He's learning on the podcast.
Wow, I'm just like a teacher here.
Yeah. Hey, fuck learning. We don't do that on this show anymore.
I remember playing darts and just railing.
Oh, yeah, wall. Man. Like, if you look at that wall close up, there's just, like, dots all the way down. So, especially because people would just miss on purpose and shit, so.
I would get you to stand in front of it.
Yeah. What I would get you to do. Let's play darts. I'll play goalie.
Oh, boy.
What makes you feel like you're going back a few years? What do you mean? Like, just the...
All the stuff?
Or, like...
It's like... No, I'm just saying. Like, you got fucking...
Gretzky's. Oh, okay. All right. I see what you're saying.
You know, like, I feel
what
like...
What the fuck is this shit?
Like, you have a DVD player?
Blu-ray.
Okay,
you.
Blu-ray.
Not that anyone uses that, but... well, that's a... Yeah, anyways. Who knows what year that's from? This is the winter classic. The first outdoor classic. Often unacknowledged. By the greater hockey community. Working on getting some better stuff. I want to switch out some pictures, get like a picture. There's this cool poster of Elon Musk, like from, like the picture of him from Joe Rogan.
I'm taking a week.
Where he's like smoking a joint and is like doing the one eyebrow thing. It's actually pretty cool, but it's super expensive. So,
how much is it?
It was like $200 US or something like that.
For a poster?
Yeah.
Is it framed?
No, but it was like canvas. Like it looked nice, but it was like, I don't know. We'll start a GoFundMe for the show to get donations for that, or whatever posters company can be our first advertiser.
Yeah, and, sponsorship opportunity here, guys. Sponsorship
opportunities. So, yeah, inquire today at
780-994. I don't remember the last four digits, but
is it 0770?
Yeah, let's put it out there.
I think it is.
We'll put all but one digit, and everyone else can guess.
Yeah, there you go.
780-994-070, and the last digit is one I just repeated.
Perfect.
So,
no,
girls, if you guys want a probably below average time, call it.
That's good. Oh man. Well.
Maybe we'll get a couple live reviews on a next show.
What do you mean?
Of his?
Dude, that literally sounded like my phone number.
Nah, we were just talking about accounting stuff.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, God. You know what I was thinking of today?
What?
Well, because last show, like, we took, like, we were still figuring out how to do the recording, but, like, taking pee breaks every 30 minutes.
Yeah, what about it?
Well, because, like, Joe Rogan records for 3 hours without stopping. Like,
They don't go pee?
Oh, yeah. Some guys do. Some guys do, and they get up and go, and or if there's a few people, but if it's like one-on-one, but like there's never cuts or anything, right? And then it's very seldom him by himself talking, or like he never leaves the room. So maybe I don't know. He's
got a huge bladder,
dude. He's got like a disciplined bladder or something.
He's got a fucking huge dome, so he probably has a huge bladder too. So.
But that's what I was thinking about, man. Like it was like, I'm just sitting there thinking like, I mean, we can pause it, Dylan.
Just because I went doesn't mean you can.
I have to go, man.
Oh, it's all good, dude. All
right. Okay, so on that note, oh wait, by the time people hear this, your episode will already be out, but I believe you have another Invictus episode coming out this week.
No.
Oh, why not? Because
the guy I'm interviewing is actually out of town until next week.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, I listened to that one.
Next week is my show, so...
I'm just going to release it on...
Oh, you have a show coming out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Give me just going to release it on your day.
I'll schedule it for like 10 a.m. and you're like 9:59 for release.
And I'm going to fucking market the shit out of it.
Yeah. I'll cancel all my appointments. Need to post stories about my...
Do you want to be petty? Yeah. I'll be petty, dude. No, he's out of town, so I'll record next week.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Is it someone local or?
Yeah. So.
What's your show on?
So.
The Millennial
Home. Well, Dylan, it's the Millennial Home. It's, I don't know, it's about like.
Kinda, is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Cool.
So it's like, I don't know, just.
Give me the premise. Give me like a little snippet.
So
is he going to watch it? Who knows?
Yeah, who
probably.
Knows? Maybe. So it's educating the next generation of home buyers is what.
What are you going to educate them on?
Everything, right? So my first episode was like condo versus house.
Okay.
And like pros and cons of each.
I read
the
that.
Realities, right? So did you listen to it then?
No, I did not. Okay. I didn't even know.
Listen to his beautiful voice.
Okay. Man, what? There's clearly a SoundCloud link at the top of that podcast. But no, so what essentially what it was is like we sort of started blogging with our real estate website together way back in the day and kind of sporadically did it, and I've like written a lot
of sort of
sporadically is overstating it.
So we were a team for like what, like a year and a half?
Yeah.
2 years almost.
2 years, yeah.
I think we put out like 4 blog posts. So yeah, sort of
semi-annually.
Yeah, you know, like once in a while. You know, it's like the Dom Mazzetti thing. It's like new videos every when I feel like it.
That's honestly, yeah, that's the premise for our other shows. But yeah, so anyways, condo versus home, just pros and cons of each. And yeah, I don't know. Oh, so what I was saying is that like I kind of started writing my own content and stuff. And like, so I went through all my files and stuff and I had like lots and lots of like long articles of like 1500, 2000 words and stuff that were sort of incomplete or I just never did anything with. And then as we kind of got into doing this, I'm like, okay, well, like this seems like a good channel to do it. And I wanted to put out like content real estate wise. Cause like SEO, like it helps a lot on the local level too. Right. So,
this is what broke off into my drink. So
yeah. So, I mean, anyways, it's taking my experience and kind of like educating our generation, the next generation, like as they get into real estate. Cause I've been in it for a while now, like actively selling homes. So
yeah. I'll learn what kind of home I should buy.
You should buy a fucking mansion, Dylan.
Yeah.
And then, like, buy LeDuc, too?
Yeah. But buy the $4.5 million house I just went on the market over there. Did you see that?
No, I didn't.
You don't see that?
No.
I'll send you guys a link.
Nice.
There's a big house, like, on the way out to Beaumont. Maybe it's past Beaumont, because it's out to LeDuc. But, yeah, there's, like, one that has, like, this huge, like, driveway. You know, I'm sure you know which one I'm talking about. You've always looked, like, when you're driving out there, you, like, look to your right, and there's, like, this huge just house in the middle of nowhere.
And it's going out to Beaumont?
LeDuc. Beaumont. Same direction. I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
There's not really anything like that on the LeDuc. It must be Beaumont. Like, it's by itself, like an Anchorage.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But
anyways. I've
seen it before.
Huh. Yeah. Well, if you need a $2.3 million mansion, I got one listed, so... But I don't know. I kind of just wanted to do like more something to combine like this because I think this is like a good medium and space to get into mixed with like real estate expertise. And then also for me, like I kind of wanted to light a fire under my own butt of like we have more friends and acquaintances becoming realtors, like, yeah, now. But I've been doing it for 4 years, so I want to differentiate myself.
I have a lot of realtor friends.
Yeah. It's crazy. I mean, yeah, you do too, right? So, but kind of like really separate myself from the pack, because I have performed at a higher level than even people
who've been doing it. Bro, you're not a realtor.
Why not?
You're a associate broker.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sorry, I'm an associate broker.
You're not a realtor.
And a member of the Realtors Association of Edmonton, so on.
Yeah. Don't sell yourself short, bro.
Thanks, Josh. Appreciate the reminder. Go
the extra mile.
Yeah. Yeah, read that email signature of mine, I guess. So, anyway, so me and Josh were supposed to be doing that. Is it semi-monthly? Like every 2 weeks, like alternate?
Yeah.
But Josh fucked up the whole schedule.
I'm sure I could find somebody else to interview, dude.
No, no.
If you want me to put one out on Thursday.
Fine. Well, see, the thing about that one, or either of us, because we're doing it less regular, like, you have more time to promote it, right? No. That's even a problem with this, or like a bottleneck for this is like, because I like to do our clips for the Instagram, but like that takes a while to make, and then to actually make them and then
you only get a week.
Distribute them. And I only have so many days to put it out before it's the next show, and it feels weird using old ones. Old stuff. So.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
You don't want to be using old shit.
So. No. Yeah. Stay relevant.
Yeah, exactly. So, but anyways, a millennial homeowner and, Invictus, part of the Long and Hard Media Network, so like and subscribe.
You want to start a podcast, bro?
Always. What do you want me to talk about? Numbers?
What are you good at? Yeah, just start counting honestly, on the microphone. Just say one.
We'll bring people in.
Two.
No, here's what we'll do.
Every week is a new one.
We're going to call it three.
No, sorry, what were you saying?
Oh, we'll do calculator races. I'll bring a new guest every in, and if they beat me, they get $1,000.
Nice. That's a good idea.
Like a game show?
Yeah.
Yeah, like a game show.
I like it. Can we be the host?
That'd be dope.
What's a calculator race, though?
Like, okay, so we print off a bunch of numbers from Excel, because I'm pretty good on the calculator.
Okay.
Pretty good. I'm kind of like a champion at my firm sometimes.
Yeah, but explain what a calculator
is. Okay, so we print off a bunch of numbers in a column from Excel, and you got to add them all up. Obviously, we total them in Excel, so we know what the total is, and you got to do it on a calculator as fast as you can. And when you're done, hopefully you beat me, you get some money. If you don't, something shitty happens to you.
Get like fucking... Do you guys remember the show Uh-Oh that was on?
Really
with just where you get like slimed? Yeah, or it was just the Punisher. The Punisher, which was kind of a weird thing to have kids for, because it was a dude in like a gimp suit, basically, and he was dumping slime on you.
I was literally going to say Uh-Oh. Yeah. That's too funny. Yeah.
And the host was like some weird... I don't know. And the set was really strange. Like
YTV,
colored.
Dude. Yeah. YTV.
Classic. Yeah. Is that still around?
I have no idea. I don't know. No idea.
I believe MTV like still exists and stuff.
Yeah,
who knows what the hell's on
that's
it.
That's not really YTV. YTV is YouTube.
It's Channel 14. Yeah.
This guy knows what's up, dude. Yeah, but now you should start something, bro.
Was 13 much music?
I don't know.
No, 13 was like ABC.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
And 11 was the Weather Network.
Yeah. No, 21. Was it? It was 21.
Yeah.
How the fuck do you remember
this? Yeah, it's 21. 23 is Sportsnet. Yeah, well, Sportsnet, a lot of them are still the same. Yeah.
22 is KPS. What's that like?
24, 24 was PS.
Yeah.
Well, whatever the fuck. Spokane. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I think so.
Arthur and shit.
Yeah. The Spokane channels for
PBS.
Whatever goddamn reason. Yeah.
PBS, bro.
Was 19 like country music or something?
I don't know. Number 4
it might
was
have been
CBC.
CMT, yeah.
CBC, number 4.
Yeah.
7.
Do you remember... Do you know why this was? But like back in the day, to like turn on your Xbox or your TV, you had to be changed to a certain channel.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Or like...
It had to be on 4.
Or CIBC. Or CIBC.
CIBC.
But like...
CBC.
I don't remember that.
Not
no,
the like, bank channel, dude.
Yeah. So like GameCube... Like maybe even like more Nintendo days, like N64 days, like... Your TV had to be on a certain channel to, like, change the inputs for whatever reason.
Not my TV.
Oh, really?
No.
I mean, this was... We weren't allowed to have N64.
You had a good TV.
Yeah, I guess he did.
No, so. I don't think I did, but...
I don't know. I was remembering that. It was kind of a weird thing that made no sense why that was a thing, so...
Technology, bro. It's come a long way.
Yeah, honestly, though.
It's come a long way.
It's crazy.
I still remember playing N64 and being like, this is amazing.
Yeah, and then it, have you ever seen N64 graphics like now, and you look at it, and you're like...
You're like, holy fuck.
Yeah, like, how did we think this was cool?
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Or like, good.
Or you, you know, you push a joystick one way and like responds in 3 seconds.
I think the camera just died on us.
Oh. Oop. Oop. Well, then I guess we'll wrap it up pretty quick here.
Oh, no. Change on the fly.
I wonder if the mic heard that.
What?
The fucking...
The little click.
Shutter closing.
You actually could hear it on the other episode because we just didn't have the extra battery, so we just kept recording.
Yeah.
And then...
Don't worry, Dill, I'll throw a transition in here. King of transitions.
Yeah. But, like, keep the audio going. But anyways, last time you could hear it, and it was like, click, and then, like, oh. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, shit, I think the camera just died. And then I'm like, but we'll keep talking. And then, yeah, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, moving up in the world with in terms of podcast quality here. So, you're welcome, everyone.
Yeah. Level 4K camera next week.
Yeah. And then the little arms, microphone arms, like, stick them on the tables.
Ooh, yeah.
So then you can have the things just right in your fucking face. Like, you like it. Like
$400 so, yeah. Each.
You can do it with these, actually. Like, this one has, like...
A mount?
Yeah, it has, like, a screw hole in the bottom.
Well, I mean, like, I do have the thing at my house. Like, I could bring my mic.
You have your... Yeah.
Yeah.
The issue is you need a mixer, right?
And I don't know
how the fuck you use a USB mic if there's, like, a USB mixer. Like,
you're getting a little bit dicey there. Yeah. Then you need, like, a...
In theory,
pastor or something.
Yeah. Unless you went all the same brand. I don't fucking know.
So, yeah. It gets a little bit hairy. I mean, you could probably figure it out.
I have no idea what you guys are talking about, but...
Oh, yeah. Sorry. We're extremely technically knowledge on this subject now, so...
Yeah, I know how to use a microphone.
Nice. Yeah, bro. When are you guys going to do the intro with... Both of you singing on it.
Both of us singing.
Yeah.
Did we promise that?
I kind of... That's what Josh promised me today, actually.
Oh, really?
Sorry, bro.
It's okay. We have two microphones. We know a lot about microphones now.
I got two phones.
Two mics. Yeah, we'll have that coming up. I mean, I got...
What about like
this
a live?
This is basically a music studio down here, right?
So. What, you guys should go to the street one day with your podcast.
There's actually some dudes out there who do like, I don't know what the fuck they're called, but they literally just sit down like at a table with a mic, like a Canadian Tire table, and be like, come, and they have a big sign that says, come be on our podcast, we'll interview you about whatever.
That's
apparently,
a good idea.
Apparently they're really funny, like they're comedians or something.
That's a good idea.
So.
You're doing a White Ave.
Saturdays. 1:30 a.m.
That would be honestly be better to like do like a on location sort of TV show, like get a camera and then have a mic and then just like,
oh yeah,
yeah,
1:30 a.m.
all right, 1 a.m.
oh boy,
no,
yeah, can I come out
30 a.m.
yeah. If this ever happens, I need this on air that you guys agree to bring me on this one.
Absolutely.
I'll carry the camera.
Is
no
this
problem.
Like, so you have it in writing?
Yeah,
hang on. Click. Yeah, sure, I'll do it. Click.
God damn.
Maybe we'll find you a girlfriend.
No, probably not. At 2:30 a.m.?
Probably not.
That's where I'm going to find my girlfriend, dude. 100%.
Yeah, when those their standards are lowered.
The chick, like, just munching on a donair.
Yeah.
Donair sauce all over her face is dripping
do
down.
Do a collaboration with whatever donair shop on white there and, you know. Donair shop interviews. I like it. Good content piece.
Yeah. If
nice.
They interview, they get like 10% off their donair.
Oh, okay. All right.
What's like the donair shop on white called?
Fuck. It's not Marco.
No free advertising.
Yeah. Donair shops on white. God.
Subway's his.
Oh, yeah.
Subway's this guy.
Subway. I have a funny story about Subway. Remind me to tell you once we stop recording, but. I
oh,
think
it's inappropriate for the show?
Yeah, it is. But anyways, did I even start the video again? Fuck, I hope I did. I'm just thinking, like, I think I just put the battery in and put it on the thing.
Oh, well.
Yeah. All right, well, I think that's probably enough for
I'll just draw
this week.
A huge dick on the fucking video for the last 3 minutes.
Just on paint. The best would be if you did it on paint, but instead of saving the picture, take a screenshot so you can tell it's paint, and then use that picture.
Dude, if you didn't record the video, 100% what I'm doing. Sorry to tell you.
All right.
Hold me to it.
Sounds good. I was telling Josh before the show that, like, because you know we do, like, an intro song now?
Yeah.
I'm going to, like, ask people and be like, oh, do you have, like, a song you want me to use? Like, it can be one you really like or that means something to you or whatever. And I'm like, oh, yeah, great. And give me a song. And then I'll just, maybe we should cut this so people don't hear us. But then I'll just use some random fucking song, like Airplanes by B.O.B.
Yeah. All right.
Well, thanks for joining us, friend of the show.
Yeah, Dylan thanks Trance. For having me.
I have a beer in my hand. I can't clap, yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Hopefully you guys enjoy having someone else for us to banter with. So that made the weirdest fucking sound in the mic. Oh, wait. That was me clapping. Never mind.
Yeah, it wasn't my mouth, dude. Yeah. Don't you worry about it.
Oh, God. Oh, man. There's so many. I don't know. I just don't want to get into, like, a chirping battle for no goddamn reason, but...
Let's fucking do it.
Well, I also couldn't think of it on the fly. I needed to try and buy some time there, but it didn't really work, so...
All right, well, suck my dick. Well, from the Long and Hard Studios, yeah. This is Josh Blaze.
And Thomas, and...
Dylan.
Dylan. And thanks we'll, for listening. Yeah, thanks for listening, thanks for watching. You know where to, like and subscribe and listen and anywhere you get your podcasts and at Long and Hard Podcasts and new videos whenever we want. So be sure to stay tuned.
Could be tomorrow. Could be fucking 5 weeks from now. Who knows? Peace.
Yeah. Peace out.